Good morning, students. Once again, welcome back to C++ class. In this class, here I am going to explain you about the process of writing a C++ program. See, when you are writing a C++ program, way to write and how to write, how to compile, how to execute, that we'll discuss today. See, already we completed a C programming. In C programming, how you write the program? See, you will open developer C++ editor. This is called as the IDE editor, and where you will write the program. After writing the program, you will compile the program. After that, you will run the program. Okay. So this is a simple process when you are writing a C program. Similarly, when you are writing a C++ program also, there is a process, means where to write, what library files you have to include, what object files you have to include, that we'll discuss now. Okay, so when you are writing the C program, here we have a list of steps you need to follow. The steps. Okay, so I'll give you the list of the steps. So the first one is first step. Editor. Okay. What is an editor? Editor is the place where you will write the program. Okay. So, in our lab, what we are using is IDE editor, Integrated Development Environment. Developer C++ editor we are using. That is an IDE editor. Okay. Is an editor. Now, what is the use of the editor? Actually, in editor, we will write the source program. What is the source program? Whatever program the user is writing, that program is called as a source program. Means before performing a compilation and execution, whatever a raw program you are writing, that is called as a source program. Where we'll write that source program? In the editor. So which editor we are using in our lab? Developer C++ IDE editor we'll use. I think you all know how to open editor. Now, here in editor, what we write? Source file to write. Okay. Source file to write. In a source file, after writing the file, after writing the program, what name you will give? File name dot cpp. File name dot cpp. In case of C program, we used to give file name dot c. In case of C++, what we'll give? We'll give file name dot cpp. Okay, cpp is C++. Now, after that, here the second one is preprocessor. Preprocessor. Preprocessor means like we used to include a hash include. Hash include. stdio.h. Okay, this header file in C programming we have included. Okay, so what is the use of that? Ash means what actually? It is a preprocessor. Okay, preprocessor command. And what is the use of the preprocessor command? Preprocessor command. Actually, what is the use of this preprocessor command is? See, example, if you want to include any library files from a C++ software, that line and that you want to include before starting your programming execution. Okay, then we'll include by using the preprocessor. This is the preprocessor directives. Okay, and how preprocessor directive is included? By using a hash. Hash is nothing but a preprocessor command. So whatever preprocessor, whatever library file you are including, whatever files are available in that, all those files will be invoked into your program. Okay, in the C programming, what example I have given? stdio.h, that is enter file. In stdio.h, print a function, scan a function, means to execute that functions, whatever instructions you need, you will get from that header file. Similarly, here what we are doing, in order to run C program, C++ program, whatever basic functionality, whatever basic files you need, that we are including using a preprocessor directive. Next one is compiler. compiler. This process is called as a compilation. Okay, so compilation is nothing but it is a process of converting your source code into an object code. Okay, whatever code you have written, that code is converted into an object code, that is called as an intermediate code. Okay, and in a compilation process, we'll check is there any error in the program or not. If there is any error in the program, and then it will throw the error, we'll do the correction. Again, we'll compile the program. So, if your program is compiled successfully, then object code will be generated. Whatever source code, whatever code you have created, that is a source code. Whatever code is generated after the successful compilation, that is an object code. Okay. Next, after the compilation process, the next one is a linker. It links other object codes. Okay. It links other object codes. See, whatever object, whatever code you have generated after the compilation, that is object code. And using the linking section, what happened? Other object code which are required to execute your program, that will be combined with your object code. Next one is the loader. And what is the use of the loader? It will load your program into the memory. It will load your program into the memory. Next, at last you can see here, just I'm changing this. After the loader, the next one is CPU. After the loader, what happened? Your program is executed. Next, after the CPU, the next one is the output. This is a simple process to write a C program. So, when you are writing a C program, here we have a few steps. First one is you need to open the editor. There you need to write the CPP file, CPP program, and get the file extension as .cpp. Next, after writing the program, you include the preprocessor directives. Preprocessor directives are needed, which loads the different programs into your different files into your program. Next, after including the preprocessor command, you compile your program. When you compile your program, your source code will be converted into the object code. Okay, and that object code is understood by the system. Next, after compiling, your object code is linked with other objects code in order to execute your program. Next, loader. After linking your object code with another objects, that program should be loaded into your memory. Next, your program will be executed by the CPU. Last, you will get the output. So, this is a simple process of writing a C++ program. Now, I'll give you the structure of C program. What is the structure of C++? Okay, see how you have a structure in a C programming, like the first one is a document section, the next one is a definition section, global declaration section, linking section, main section, subsection. Similarly, means in the same sequence you need to write the program. Similarly, for C++ also, there is a particular structure to write the program. That structure we will discuss now. Come to structure of C++ program. The first one is document section. So, this section is already known by you. That is, in the document section, we will give a comment about the program. Means what is the name of the program? Who is the author of the program? That will give inside the document section. The next one is preprocessor section. The preprocessor, again we have subsections. So the linking section. The second one is definition section, third one again global declaration section, global declaration section. Okay, this is all already we discussed in our C programming. Next one is the class declaration. After the class declaration, you give the opening brace, the closing brace. There only you give data members and member functions. This is a class declaration. After closing the class, write the main function. In the main function, again you open the brace and close the brace. I think it is not visible. Again, I am changing this. Just a minute. Main function. Inside the main function, again here object creation. Next, calling member functions. Okay, as it is, you take a screenshot first. Second, third, fourth, fifth, last. You take screenshot of this. I will explain one by one in detail. Now, we will discuss about documentation. Document section. This section is also called as a commenting section. Means we'll comment about the program. Means what is the name of the program? What is the purpose of the program? What variables we have used? What tools we have used? That we'll discuss in the document section. So in C++ program, it is similar to C programming, where there are two types of comments. One is a single line comment, and the second one is a multi line comments. Document section. What's it called? It's a comment section. There are two types of comments. One is a single line comment, and the second one is a multi line comment. Okay, single line comment starts with two forward slashes, and whatever comment you want to give, that you give. Next, multi line starts with asterisk, forward slash, give the comment, and first you close the asterisk, then you give the comment. Okay, so in C also we did this. Okay, single line comment we used to give two forward slashes. And whatever comment you want to give, that you can give. In multi-line comment, what happened? We are giving a forward slash, asterisk, give the comment, and give the asterisk. Means in the reverse order, you close it. Okay, so this is a document section. Now, we will discuss about preprocessor directives. Preprocessor section. Preprocessor. See, already I have explained ash include stdio.h in C programming. What is the use of that header file? See, if you want to write a printf, scanf, or a main function, we need a stdio.h. Means, in order to execute that basic functions, we are getting instruction from a header files. So, before executing your program, before executing some functions in your program, so whatever files are needed, whatever instructions are needed to run that program, that should be loaded into your memory. And that is possible by using a preprocessor section. Preprocessor section, again, it is divided into two things. One is a link section. The second one is a definition section. So, link section like this, ash, include. In C programming, we used link like this, ash, include, stdio. Standard input and output header files, whatever functions are available in this header file, that will be loaded into your program. But in case of a C++ program, here we use the string, ash include, io string, I am using dot h. Then what about whatever functions are there? The means the basic function. In order to write a basic program, also we need some functions. That functions instructions you will get from this iostream.h. This is a preprocessor direct. Now the next one is the definition section. See, I like this hash define. If you want to create a global constants, then here we use hash define. Hash define by 3.1. This also I have already explained in our C program. Hash define by 3.14. So this is a constant variable, static variable, and this variable can be used by all the functions available in the C program. And the life of this variable start when you start the program execution, and the life of this variable will end when you stop the program execution. Okay, so these are all static variables. Okay, constants these are. This is a two section. So if frequently if you are using any variable with more than one function, so instead of redefining the same variable number of times, here we can create a global variable like this. Next, global declaration. Want to use a same variable in more than one place number of times, then you can declare that variable as a global variable. So global variable can be used more than one function in the same program, and that global variables are declared before the main function. Okay, like a float, a 10.5 example. So this is a global variable. So, and that global variables are declared before the main function. If you have created any variable as a global, then in more than one place you can use that same variable. So that is a global declaration section. This part also already I have explained in our C programming. The next one is class declaration or a class declaration. This is a very very important section in the structure of C++ program. So whatever program you want to write, that program should be a, means everything should be included inside a class definition. And this class is a collection of data members and member functions. Okay, like in C programming we used to declare int, float, char, that are variables. So that variables are called as a data members here. Okay, next we used to operate some methods on that, like void and different methods like sum. Such type of methods will come under the member functions. Okay, so here class is a collection of data members and member function. But here what is the difference is when you are creating any data members and member function, then here you need to use the access specifiers. Public, private and protected. Okay, this is the data members. Next, data members and methods also here we'll declare inside this access specifier. So, why we are using this public, private and protected? See, private, public. If you want to allow all the classes to use your class variable, then that variable should be declared as a public. And if you are allowing your child classes to use the methods, like a publicly, if you want to give a permission to all the child classes to use your method, that should be declared as a public. Okay, means any child class can use your class properties and your class methods. The next one is a private. Private means if you don't want to give a permission to other classes to use your class properties, that can be declared as a private, like a float a, float a, next to void, some example. Then what happened? This two property is used by your class only. You are not giving the permission to any other classes. So if you want to give a security for your data, then that type of variables can be declared inside the private access specifiers. These are called as access specifiers. The next one is a protect. Here, if you are giving a permission to few classes to use your members, then what happened? That can be declared as a protected. So depends on the access permissions. You can declare your data members and your member function inside a public, private, or protected. So these are three important access specifiers which gives a permission to your class members and your member functions. If you have created any variable inside the public, that variable can be used by any class, or even it is a child class or it is a other class from a other file. Next, if you have created any variable or any function inside the private, that properties can be used by only your class. And the protected. Protected is also, it won't give permission to other classes to use your property, but this protected members can be used by this class, child class. Okay, child classes can use this property. This is the class. Now, the next section is the structure of C programming languages. Main function. Main. Like in C programming, you have a void main. What is the use of the void main? From the void main, only a program execution will be start. Similarly, in C++ also, there is a main function, and that your program execution start from the main function. And that is like this, void main. And after the main function, give the opening brace. Okay, so from this point, your program execution will be start. And here, we'll create an object. Example class name is C, C1. Name of the object is OB. Next to new C. This is a simple example for object creation. If you have created any object of a class, that means if you have created an object for the class, then whatever methods, whatever variables are available in that class, that can be accessed by the object. Okay, example in that class, we have a method called sum. Then OB.sum. Then whatever function definition is there, whatever you have written inside this function, that will be executed. This is the execution section and closing the main function. So this is the process of writing a C++ program in a structure of C++ program. So in a structure of C++ program, the first section is a document section. What is the use of the document section? In a document section, we'll give the comment of the program. Means, what is the purpose of the program, when it is created, additional information you can add by using a document section. Again, document section is divided into two categories. One is a single line comment and the second one is a multi-line comment. Okay. Now, the next come to a preprocessor section. In the preprocessor section, we'll link library files into your program. So that you can write, then you can use a simple basic functions to write the program. The next one is in a linking section only. In a preprocessor only, we have a linking section and a definition section. Using a definition section, you can create a static variables that can be used by any function in the program. So after that, we have a global declaration section. In a global declaration section, we'll create some global variables that can be used by all the function that is created before the class definition. Next one is a class. Whatever program is there, whatever source code is there, whatever you want to write in a C++, all those will write inside the class only. So this class is a collection of data members and member functions. For each and every data member, you need to give the access specifier. Access specifier means it's accessing right. Means whether you want to give a permission to all the other classes to use your properties or not. If you want to give permission to use all your property, that's a public. If you don't want to give permission to other classes to use your property, that's a private. And only for child classes, we are giving up access rights to use the properties. That is a protect. Next, after closing the class, you give the main function. What is the use of the main function? In the main function only, we'll create the object. and when the object is created, you will get a memory to load your class. And once the memory is loaded, then you can execute your program. Then you will get an output. So this is a simple structure of C++ program. In the next class, I will show you the execution part. So I will show you this is a program in the system.